With over 100 demos at OktoberTech, today I'm going to give you a sneak peek of three demos tied to power. We're going to show you a new power device technology called a GaN bi-directional switch. Then we're going to show you breakthroughs in power delivery technologies for AI processors. And finally, we're going to show you how we can use three different technologies combined, GaN, silicon carbide, and silicon, to create the highest power density, highest efficiency systems in the world. So I'd love to know what you think about this. Go ahead and leave some comments below. And with that, let's go check out some demos. So Tiziano, I hear you've got some cool technology. Tell me about it. What do you got here?
I do, Adrian, thank you. So this is the new gallium nitride BDS technology that we are providing to our customers starting next year. Those devices right here are two of our BDS devices. What's new in those devices is, first of all, they are made of gallium nitride.
Okay.
This allows them to switch at frequencies that are not possible with our silicon devices. This board runs at 400 kilohertz all the way up to 1 megahertz. That allows the system to be very compact, and simply you can remove the core material from our magnetics. So you can reduce space, volume, and weight out of your power supply. The second feature of those two devices here are the fact that they are BDS, bidirectional devices. This means that they can block and conduct current in both directions. This feature is typically done nowadays by back-to-back connected silicon devices or gallium nitride devices in unidirectional mode. So you can simply replace two discrete unidirectional devices with one BDS device. If you want a 100 million device in BDS, you would have to replace it with four 100 million unidirectional devices. So typically the application for this would be either micro inverter, okay, typically used in solar applications, or in EV chargers, where those devices, having the capability of conducting current in both directions, can allow you to have flow of power from the main to the DC source, or the other way around, where the DC source, being your battery, becomes the source of power for your to be transferred back to your AC line. The efficiency of this system is unparalleled. There is no silicon-based converter that can match the efficiency of gallium nitride and BDS in gallium nitride nowadays.
For that size and for that weight.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Great, well, thank you very much. Thanks for sharing.
Thank you.
Rakesh, this looks like a powerful demo. What are you showing me?
We got a couple of interesting demos.
Okay.
This is showcasing our Gen 1 high-density power modules powering AI processors. And this is our Gen 2, the newest benchmark in the industry, launched just recently.
So I do want to get to that, but maybe before we go there, tell me a little about Gen 1 and what's unique about it and what's special.
So this is a unique system design, truly enabling vertical power delivery for power-hungry processors. We blend Infineon's best-in-class MOSFET technology with a thermally enhanced chip emitter packaging.
Okay.
That ensures that you continue to push system Moore's law in solving power delivery for AI system. We have to continue to innovate at a component level also, so we have a unique patented Infineon inductance IP. And this makes it completely different from anything else available in the market.
And that's these guys right here that we're talking about.
Yeah, we use the inductor not only to conduct current, but also to transfer temperature. This allows a very simple design without compromising performance or quality. If you take any competing solution, this is about easily 2 to 3% higher efficiency. 2 to 3%, if I translate into data center world, that's roughly multi-million dollar savings in just utility cost.
Very cool. Gen 2, tell me about that.
Yeah, so this is Gen 1, but the demonstration shows a lateral power delivery.
Yeah.
Sure, you can use it for vertical. There are some of our key customers doing it today.
Okay.
What Gen 2 does is truly enables that in a different dimension, because we continue to innovate on the MOSFET technology. We build on top of the packaging that we established in Gen 1. Now we have a 30% smaller power solution, yet delivering the same amount of current. This system is geared to deliver thousands of amps, and each of these components are rated for 160 amp in an 8x8mm package.
Well, thank you very much. I appreciate you taking the time.
Thank you, pleasure is mine.
So Sam, I know we're here at the tail end of demo day, but you're showing off some pretty big power supplies. Can you tell me what these are for, where these are going, and what's cool about them?
We're telling a story of the server switch mode power supplies.
Okay, got it.
And we see the trend for AI servers, and the power is going higher density, and they're pushing the envelope of the power, right?
And these power supplies are for when a server, you bring in AC, into the server assembly?
Into the server rack that takes an AC output to 48 volts to the server boards.
Right? Okay, got it.
So, and these are different form factor like you see. So the first one, we call it MCRPS. This is modular common redundant power supply.
Okay.
And this is 3.3 kilowatt. It's really state-of-the-art power density and efficiency, 97.5%. We try to position the three technologies from Infineon, silicon carbide, gallium nitride, and silicon, to capture the best figure of merits and efficiency and power density.
Why these other ones? This looks nice and small. Why
so,
are you these
so this
ones?
Is a segment we call the enterprise, or MCRPS. This is a power supply on the motherboard of the server board, right?
Okay.
If you go to the hyperscale, we have these power supply that go into a power shelf. We're using the next generation Gen 2 GaN, Gen 2 silicon carbide, and also higher switching frequency on the LLC up to 1.5 megahertz. This power supply is 8 kilowatt, right? And really with 8 kilowatt, 6 power supplies in a shelf, we're talking about, you know, 48 kilowatt, but this is not enough. Right?
It's not enough.
Right? All right. So I think one of the challenges of AI is keeping up with the power. So this shelf, right, will also take the next generation of 12 kilowatt. So you end up with 72 kilowatt per power shelf. We have a new technology of silicon carbide that's based on 400 volts silicon carbide, 400 volts voltage class.
Okay.
It's a brand new voltage class that's really enable you to go into low profile design. And if you look at this power supply, it's actually 2 6-kilowatt sandwiched.
This has
an intermediate stage, we call it the power pulsating. It's an energy buffer. So it's acting like it's absorb all this load jump inside the power supply and control how much you take from the grid. So it's really a grid-friendly power supply that will relieve a lot of the stress on the grid side or the medium voltage transformer or the utility side.
So big deal if you're designing
this
a server.
This is a big deal.
Oh, very cool. Well, hey, thanks for showing me these.
Yeah.
So that's cool.
Welcome. Thank you.
So I hope you enjoyed all those great demos. Please remember to comment below. I'll see you next time. Stay innovative.